No. You have to prove at your home root 3 is irrational. And also in exercise 1.3 in NCRT, it is given that prove that root 5 is irrational. So you will solve all these problems by same way. So I hope you will do at your home. I hope you are honest and you are doing honestly at your home. So after, when school will reopen, I must go through your homework. Now, I want to solve a problem of this group. How root 7 is irrational? How root 7 is irrational? How will you proceed? This is a question. This method is known as contradictory method. Very popular method it is. You may solve so many problems. And this type of problem was, this type of problem had been asked, or you say has been asked in the examination also. So, now how will you proceed? This is a question. Let us assume that root 7 is rational. This is a contradictory method. So, we here consider, you have to prove irrational, or we suppose rational. That's why it is known as contradictory. This is opposite. So, this is known as contradictory method. So, let us assume that root 7 is rational, which in simplest form, this word is also important. Simplest form, where AB belongs I or Z. You must write, you must mention in your copy. While you are solving the problem, you must, while you will be solving this problem, you must mention it. Here, suppose root 7 is equal to a by b, where a and b both are integers, and secondly, a and b both are coprime or in simplest form. Now, second step, we want to prove that 7 is common factor of a. So, for this purpose, we squaring both sides and a square is equal to 7b square. What does it mean? It means a square is divisible by 7 and a square is also divisible by b square. But here, we want only this branch, a square is divisible by 7. A square is divisible by 7. So 12 is equal to, suppose, 4 into 3. So 12 is divisible by 4. And 12 is divisible by 3 square. 6 square is equal to 9 and 4. So 6 square is divisible by 9. And 6 square is divisible by 4. You must take care. Now, squaring both sides, we have a square is equal to 7b square. Since 7b square is divisible by 7, a square is also divisible by 7b square. It is also true. A square is divisible by 7. So, a is divisible by 7. Just I have written, in case when I have proved that root 2 is irrational. So now, you write, A is divisible by 7. So A is a number of multiple of 7, where M belongs to it. So A is equal to 7M. A is equal to 7M. So now, where m belongs to some integer, you say. Some integer. So now you say, so in this way, just I proved first part. A is divisible by 7. Now here in question, suppose this is equation first. In first, it is given that a square is equal to 7b square. A square is equal to 7b square from first. The 49m square is equal to 7b square. So b square is equal to 7m square. It means 7 divides b square. 7 divides b square. So b is also divisible by 7. Now we conclude that 7 is a common factor of both A and B, which is a contradiction. This is important. I just suppose that A and B both are in simplest form. Both have no common factor except one. And here just I proved that 7 is common in A and B. So, this is contradiction. So, by considering this, we now in a position to say that root 7 is not rational. Root 7 is irrational. Thank you very much. In this way we'll prove.